and welcome to our 5 minutes with Ekaterina. Today I want to talk to the people who right now are on the intermediate level of learning a language and are a little bit upset because they found out that there are not that many resources for your target language. You're not alone, there are so many people around that have the same problem, especially if you are learning some kind of rare language. I'm not talking about those of you who are learning English, Russian or Chinese right now, because there are enough sources for popular languages. And these languages are considered as popular, they have a lot of native speakers and so many people are learning them that it's quite profitable to write the textbooks for the intermediate level. But in such languages as, for example, Ukrainian or Romanian or some more rare languages, maybe Georgian, there are fewer materials and sometimes you feel frustrated because you get out of this beginner's level and you think that your life is going to be easier. And then you're realizing that you are finding other materials that you already done, and that makes a perfect explanation because it's just easier to create the textbook for beginners. Or you can find the advanced materials or native materials, you can see the movies and you cannot really understand what's going on there, or you can listen to the radio and again you don't understand what's going on there because people are speaking so fast. So what can you do here in this situation if you're learning a relatively hard language and you are now in your intermediate level? And the advice here is to find the native materials for teenagers. When I'm talking to people who are starting to learn a language for beginners, I discourage them to use fairy tales. I always say, no, please don't use the children's books because they usually have a complex vocabulary about witchcraft, about some things you don't even really know what it is in your native language. If you're taking a book for children in your native language, you're realizing that you cannot really translate it easily in some other language actually. So if you're a beginner, it's a bad idea to take the native materials for children, but this situation is not true if you're now in your intermediate level. So your goal now is to find the materials for teenagers, not for children, but for teenagers, children, maybe young people in the age between 12 and 16 or 12 and 17, because the books for them, they use the most simple vocabulary than you would probably meet in the adult stories. They don't use the mythological part of the culture as we do for children, these morals and these fairy tales passing through the ages with the very old ancient vocabulary. They don't use it anymore, and they don't use yet the complex vocabulary for the advanced native speakers who graduated from the university. So now you're literally in the correct place. And what can you find? You can find YouTube videos for teenagers, sometimes created by teenagers. Maybe it's not that exciting, but sometimes it is actually, sometimes they're good. So find a teenager in your target language who is doing YouTube for videos. There are plenty of them now. Or find a cartoon. There are cartoons for this age because they still like to watch cartoons and they don't like to watch the simple cartoons, which is good for us now. And you can also find magazines for teenagers, you can find some movies for teenagers, but it should be the materials designed for 12 to 17 years old. This will be easier for you and this will help you with your intermediate level. And this is a grammar, just find a grammar textbook, like really any, and follow it, stick to it, and do it. But right now, when you're in this intermediate level, grammar would be in your focus, of course, but it shouldn't be your only thing. It should help you to understand what you're doing better, because that's how you can do it easier. You can just see the grammar structure and understand it, if it's a past, present, or future, for example. But the grammar is not your main focus now. You're expanding your vocabulary, you're working on your fluency, and you're trying actually to understand these advanced materials, which will be your next step in the language learning. That's my idea for today. I hope that you found it useful. If so, write me a comment. Also, if you are an intermediate student in the language which is not that popular as English, for example, please leave a message below this video and tell which resources do you use. That would be helpful for other students who may be watching this video too. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget about your likes and subscribe for the channel and consider supporting me on Patreon. I hope to meet you very soon in our next episodes. Goodbye for now.